Legal dictation. 5 seconds. Comments. This is a petition under section 482 of the Code of Criminal Procedure for quashing the order dated 19th January 2007, whereby cognizance was taken, and a subsequent order dated 24th July 2007, whereby notice envisaged under section 251 of the Code of Criminal Procedure was given to the petitioner for the offence punishable under sections 323 and 325 of IPC, read with section 34 thereof. A perusal of the order dated 24th July 2007 would show that the learned Metropolitan Magistrate passed a speaking order stating therein that prima facie case is made out for the offence under sections 323/325/34 of IPC. Thus, the learned Metropolitan Magistrate prima facie took the view that not only the offence under section 323 but also offence under section 325 of the IPC was made out against the petitioner. Despite that, he chose to frame a notice under section 251 of the Code of Criminal Procedure instead of framing charge against him. The offence under section 325 of the Code of Criminal Procedure being punishable with imprisonment up to 7 years and fine is a warrant trial case. Though the offence under section 323 is a summons trial case. The procedure for trial of warrant cases by magistrate has been prescribed in Chapter 19 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. Section 238 of the Code provides that when in any warrant case instituted on a police report, the accused appears or is brought before a magistrate at the commencement of the trial, the magistrate shall satisfy himself that he has complied with the provisions of Section 207, which requires copies of documents, statements, charge sheet, etc. to be supplied to the accused. Section 239 of the Code provides that if on considering the police report and the document sent with it under Section 173 of the Code and examine the accused, if the magistrate thinks necessary and after giving opportunity of hearing to the prosecution as well as to the accused, the magistrate considers the charge against the accused to be groundless, he shall discharge him after recording his reasons for discharging him. If, however, the magistrate is of the opinion that there is ground for presuming that the accused has committed an offence, he shall accordingly frame charge against the accused. Thus, in a warrant trial case, it is mandatory for the learned magistrate to hear not only the prosecution but also the accused before he decides whether to discharge or to charge him. On the other hand, the procedure for trial of summons cases, which has been prescribed in Chapter 20 of the Code, provides in Section 251 that when the accused appears or is brought before the magistrate, the particulars of the offence of which he is accused shall be stated to him and shall be asked if he pleads guilty or has any defence to make, and it is not necessary to frame a formal charge. Therefore, if a warrant case is tried on a summon case, the accused would be deprived of an opportunity to seek discharge under Section 239 of the Code on the ground that there are no reasonable grounds to charge him. Section 259 of the Code provides that when in the course of the trial of a summons case relating to an offence punishable with imprisonment for a term exceeding 6 months, it appears to the magistrate that In the interests of justice, the offence should be tried in accordance with the procedure for the trial of warrant cases. He may proceed to rehear the case in the manner prescribed for trial of warrant cases.